God, who have blessed us with memory, reason, and skill, help us to use them wisely in the service of our town government. We ask this by holy name. Let's move to flag.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic which stands one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Well, I thank you all for coming. The first thing I would like to do, you have Steve's letter of resignation. Could you please read that?
Please, usually, please consider this document my formal resignation from the Town of Champlain Town Board effective 4/30/2018, Steve Southwood.
Thank you. We're interested in filling that seat this evening. It'll be a temporary appointment till the next election only. And there's 2 years left on that term, this year and next. Whoever fills the term out this year will have to run in November for the remaining 1 year term. We do have a candidate. I would like a motion to approve.
I'd like to make a motion that at this time that we approve John Burton's to a town council position for a term of 2 years.
For just the 1 year?
For the 1 year, correct.
Just 1 year, all right. Okay. This present year.
I'll second it.
Okay, thank you. Any questions, concerns? We'll have a roll call vote. Rick?
Aye.
Brian?
Aye.
Mark?
Aye.
And aye for myself, thank you. John, you are elected. Appointed.
Thank you.
Any place you want to sit. I'll tell you where the hot seat is some other time.
Julie's just got to give you the oath of office.
Okay. Go get him, please.
Oath of office. I, John Burton, do solemnly swear that I will support the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of the State of New York, and that I will faithfully discharge the duties of council member according to the best of my ability. Thank you very much.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you for the appointment.
Not that small.
Thank you. I would like approval of the minutes of April 10th. I would like to keep it more minute.
I think the only correction that I have on the minutes from April 10th is that on page number 3, I believe it was, I was the one that actually stated the question that asked about why Rouse's Point doesn't provide a gallon of fuel on their report. It wasn't Clark.
Okay. Yeah. You asked it and I answered.
Correct. Okay. Correct.
And I got that information from Juanita Munoz, who's
correct.
The treasurer of that group. He also puts together that report that we received.
Okay. Any other questions? Can I have a motion to approve it?
I'll make a motion to approve it.
Thank you.
Second.
Thank you. Any questions? If not, all those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? That's also carried. You have your town clerk's monthly board, monthly report, town clerk's monthly report. Need a motion to approve.
I make a motion that we approve the town clerk's monthly report.
Thank you.
I'll second that.
Thank you. Any questions? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? That's also carried. You have your March report for the Dog Control Officer, but you haven't done April's yet. Okay, just strictly for your information.
I have a question regarding that.
Yes.
So is that an annual training that the individual in this position goes down for?
I'm not aware of how often she has to be. Okay. I do believe the Telemore pays that if you
mean
that correctly.
Yep.
Thank you. And you have your JCO monthly outreach, monthly report. Their activities, they're quite busy. This strictly for information. We've got a few things to address this evening. We'll take them one or two at a time. Brandon Construction Company out of Plasberg was a successful bidder on the sewer pipe on the West Service Road project to be done this summer. He got the letter came to think the state portion is approved, to my knowledge. We need to approve the contract, which was back in February, I think it was. Yes, February 22nd. Okay. So I did speak with Anthony and our attorney on this one today. I've been in contact with them both several times. I asked about this with our attorney and said, yes, go ahead and approve it. So I would like a motion to approve Brandon Construction Company on Duran Road at Plasberg. The contract price is $182,100 for the West Service Road sewer line.
Pending approval by the attorney and engineers.
The attorney already approved.
Oh, he already got back? He approved it?
I talked to Matt today. Earlier today. Yes, he said, go ahead and approve that.
So he just needs the engineers to...
Yes, the engineers are the ones who make the evidence approval, okay? So if it's a will of the board, I would like that motion to approve.
I'll make that motion.
Thank you.
I'll second that.
Thank you.
Also have a question. This is the same item that we've already approved, the bonding for.
Yes.
Right, okay.
We're bonding approximately $70,000, I believe, on that issue. Okay. That's a good question. Thank you. Any other questions? If not, I'd like to have a roll call vote on a contract like this. Rick?
Aye.
Brian?
Aye.
John?
Aye.
Clark?
Aye.
And I myself, thank you.
And Larry, you also mentioned this might eliminate that manhole. You might be able to do the construction in conjunction with the state.
With the state,
save
yes.
Save us a manhole.
Yes. And we only had to get one easement up there. It's for a lift station, I believe it is. Okay. We have that in place. Okay. But this contract, to my knowledge, is a go. With a local company, that's the best part about it. Thank you. We have an email from Matt Favreau, our attorney, pertaining to the golf course lease agreement for this year only, 2018. This covers this year only. We have to renegotiate a lease going forward from next January on, okay? It is Matt Favreau's opinion, and we have discussed this in the past year, to go ahead and approve this, okay? So it's a little bit of board again. It is the recommendation of our attorney to approve.
And this is only for 2018?
2018 only.
Negotiate.
It states it right on the second page. It states
okay,
it right.
No, I just want to make yeah. sure that people know.
You're absolutely
that.
Correct, yes. Okay.
And we will be negotiating for 2019
yes.
shortly.
I have a question, Larry. What is the notice of claim? And what was that?
That was back a couple months back, January, February. If we didn't settle, they were going to put a claim against us in court. It didn't happen.
It was a formality, we were told.
Okay. Yep. they had a timeline where they had to file an intent, if they were, I don't know, it was 90 days or whatever it was, but that's gone away, so to speak. I'm waiting for the president of the club to come in and sign this. He should have been in by now, he hasn't been. But this contract was negotiated between our attorney and the golf course attorney.
Where is he?
Okay. Do I have a motion on that one? So I need a motion to approve the lease agreement for this year only, 2018.
I'll make the motion.
Thank you.
And I'll second that.
Thank you. Any questions, concerns? If not, I'll have a roll call vote on this also. Rick?
Aye.
Brian?
Aye.
John?
I'll abstain because I'm a member.
Thank you.
For golf course.
I understand. Clark?
Aye.
Aye for myself, thank you. Okay.
As a side comment, I'll mention, just by accident, I happened to encounter one of their longtime members today who knew about this, and he was very appreciative of the town and willing to work with the golf course.
Okay.
So it's, I think it's well received.
Clark, do you want to address this laws regarding the recycling mechanic?
Yes.
The one you gave me here. I read it through today. I read it through.
And you're not sure it covers anything you would like?
Well, no, but I knew a lot of it, but there's a lot of stuff I didn't know either, so.
Okay.
It's the county's law.
You learned by reading.
The history behind this, the town has experienced, continues to experience some junkyard violations or people just piling up stuff. And I know casual conversations with Mike Tatro, also Larry, there's just, we don't have the teeth to enforce what we'd like to do with the junkyards. So one day, quite by accident, I happened to see Mike Tatro, and he was in a fit of frustration. I can't remember exact words he was using, but I probably wouldn't want them in the public record. But he's very, very distraught over this. So he said, we need some teeth in the law. Now, I know that the village has recently gone through upgrading their code so that when he goes out and he sees a problem, he can follow up. And the end result is that the fine escalates, and there's actually language in there that could be jail time. So I came down and I had a conversation with Kevin Triller about, I said, what kind of language do you need to give Tatro the ammunition that he has to have to go out and enforce this? And he picked up this document off of a shelf, and he said, you know, and he started paging through it, and he found a couple of sections that were highlighted in yellow. And then he said, well, why couldn't the town just adopt the whole thing? Because it's already been done, it's already been researched by lawyers, and it's something that would fit into our code. So that's why I brought this to us here. To, and whether it's ready to send off to Favreau for review or not, I don't know. I would suggest that maybe we could adopt this in principle, that we support adopting this, and then when Mike Tatro comes back from his vacation, if you want, I'll seek him and sign. Mike, ask him if this is exactly what he needs. And if there's additional stuff in there, then this would be the appropriate time to put that language in there. And then the whole package has to get sent to an attorney who reviews it. It comes back to us, and if we accept it, we have to have a public hearing. Does that make sense?
Well, just for clarification, I'd like to have Mike Tatro go through this. He's the guy that's most affected locally.
Yes.
Then take the parts that he thinks we need, absolutely need,
right,
and send it on to our town attorney to review before we even attempt to approve it.
Okay, but it was Kevin Triller's position,
yes,
and he would be one of the two people that, yes, would actually get into the stuff. The whole thing is there, why not adapt the whole thing? Whether we should do that or not, maybe, okay. I don't know, maybe Favreau could tell us, our attorney.
Yes. That's my take on it. I'm certainly,
yeah, I'd like to wait. I'd like to see what our current law is concerning.
I know,
but I mean, this one does need to be whittled down substantially because there's like, you're talking about the landfill manager shall be responsible for all administrative duties,
right,
described in,
right,
by this law, and I think we can just take the part of it that has the teeth, the sections. Because this is written for the county municipal waste stream.
Right.
You know, they talk about recycling and things that we don't have any.
Right.
And I'd like to compare the two. I agree that there has to be teeth in the law, and I know Nikki's talked about it as the town code enforcement officer for a while, and it would be good.
Okay.
And I also probably looking at the two villages, what their laws say.
They just went through this, and they've got some language that I'm told is very gammy stiff. The option, I think, is always up to the code enforcement officer, whether they jump really quick or give warnings, give her an appearance ticket, whatever their protocol is. But ultimately, they can enforce violations. So,
yeah, so if we could just look at the two villages.
That's where the link is back, and we'll run it by him.
Yeah, and I'd like, you know, maybe we can get the Village of Champlain and the Village of Rouse's Point laws. And maybe it would be a good time to see if we could get them all saying the exact same thing. You know, so he wouldn't have a problem.
All right.
Reciprocal. Yeah, it would be great. It's all one.
Okay, so you want to table us for the time being?
I'd like to table.
When I say table, I'd like to get out to the issue though as soon as possible. Either Mike, then our attorney. I gave us a legal opinion that takes a month or two, we need to do it.
Do it right.
Okay. All right. The leveling of the city on Bob Ben Park, I don't know who wants to address that.
I'll be happy to do that. Recently, I think it was last week, I met with our cameraman in Norton Bonnell, the Celtic Castle. And I took with me a couple copies of the survey map that I got from either, I think it was Mike Tatro or Alan, you've seen this. Okay. Took this up and we started looking at where we would specifically put baseball fields. And if you follow the guideline that is put forth by National Little League Association, you're supposed to have a field run in a direction so that the batter looking out at the pitcher is facing north by northeast. Well, if you did that consistently throughout this field, then you'd be using up a lot of land in a manner which doesn't really fit the land. So I pursued that with talking with two people, Calvin and Norm, and all three of us seem to agree that if you look around at other baseball and softball fields, like across the street, none of them go in that direction. And if you look at a list of major league ballparks, which you can see online, very few of any of them go in that direction. It's simply designed so that the batter doesn't have to look into the sun. We didn't feel it was that critical to put the field exactly in that direction. I had a conversation with a man in charge of the Little League in Plattsburgh, Mike Bordall. They have many fields down there, and that's not even a concern. They just use the fields as they are. So the three of us felt that, one, it really didn't make that much difference exactly which way the field went. But what we feel is very important is that we as a group recognize that time is wasting. We have an opportunity to take at least part control of that and turn it into a baseball field. And I think that this, and also in conversation with Craig Giroux, and an email back from him today, he is supporting of this. The conversation suggested that, is it really necessary to take the entire 10 plus whatever is acres, 10.7 acres, and develop it all at once? By doing that, we're giving ourselves a bigger lawn to cut, and also we're completely taking off his opportunity to grow some corn. He was agreeable to backing off and taking a portion of this, but how much, I think that we should leave this up to Alan Racine and Craig Giroux. They've worked together on this field before, and I think that maybe the two of them deciding where exactly you put the boundary line between the corn and the grass can be very quickly worked out, and maybe the grass can be put in about the same day the corn's being planted. But I think it's important that we take full advantage of the enthusiasm of people who want to put Little League Ballpark out there. You've got coaches, you've got parents, you've got people who already are involved in this Little League program, and I understand that there are businessmen willing to contribute some money, and equipment to get this field operating. And at this point, I don't see any big cost to the town. I don't know how much grass seed costs, but it can't be that much. So, you want to take a look at the map that we talked about? I would suggest that we ask Alan to proceed with grading that off, as he's talked about doing.
Have you seen this, Alan?
So Alan's going to talk to Drew and...
I was in a field, and as you drive into the field where the driveway is, there's a hump there. And I was thinking of leveling that hump, you know, make the field as flat as we can. You know, it's hard to put the baseball mound on a hump and, you know, work that way. But we got to leave a certain amount of space for parking. They got to have at least 60 cars to be parked in. The Little League game, that's what they recommend, place for 60 parking. We got that in the front going towards the flagpole. And this is going to incorporate part, a good part of that field.
Personally, I don't have any feelings about...
I'll see what Craig's got to say, you know, I'll talk to... I'll ask Craig.
Because you're going to level it all out,
I'm going to try and level it all out as I can.
It'd be simpler to do it all at once, because, especially since it's going to take a year for this grass seed to grow. So, you know, what you're doing this year is for next year, and if we did it in two stages, nobody would be able to use the other part for another year.
We're not talking donations for like hydro seeding, are we, what are we looking at?
I don't think so.
No, this is seed that's going to have to be seeded down, like you see down the hayfield.
And when you say 60 cars, is that for one particular ball field? So are we talking 120 or are we talking 60?
No, 60, okay. At least 60 cars. We went with Mickey's recommendations with code, when they have these games. You know, sometimes they got tournaments. So you got to have room to park these cars. You don't want these cars to park in 276, put it this way.
I say just let Alan take care of it.
And I'll come up with an idea how to level it, and, you know, we'll seed it down. That would, Eric, give us turf next year to play with.
Yeah. Okay, Alan, do you want to address the issue of your possible acquiring another Lord?
We've got two proposals here to buy a new loader. We're trading in three pieces of equipment. Bring the cost down. Two of these pieces of equipment we're not using that much, so I feel we'd also get rid of them. One piece of equipment we babied all winter because it's going to need some work, and I hate to keep putting good money after that. I mean, they had priced me a price of $6,000 to fix the transmission. That's without labor. That's just the parts. And the machine's going on 30 years old, and I can't keep put that kind of money in there. So I got two proposals. They're both pretty close the same. I'm waiting for one company to give me a better description on their warranty. One guy called me this afternoon. He told me what the whole warranty is, which was pretty good. And the other, I'm just waiting for the other company to tell me. I imagine they're both the same. Found out a couple other things today that if you have a piece of equipment under warranty like this and they got to come out from Vermont to fix it, they're going to charge mileage. There's very seldom too many companies that won't charge mileage. But if you take the piece of equipment, bring it to them, they won't charge it. I mean, they won't charge you the service. So it's six to one, half a dozen to the other. If you're going to pay a man to bring the machine, like Moore's just paid the man to bring a loader to Governor, you know, it kind of whitewashes the whole thing. So in my proposal, the three pieces of equipment that I trade in makes a payment for this year. It won't cost the town nothing. This fall, when we make the budget, we got some equipment that's going to be paid off this summer. Well, as a matter of fact, one big piece is going to be paid off there the 20th of this month. And I was thinking it's going to be even, the payment on this machine is going to be even less than what we've been making. So we either make the payment, split up the payment 2 years or three, whatever, how it works in the budget this fall, how it fits in the highway budget. And I thought it was a pretty good deal because this equipment keeps going up all the time. Every year, the prices of this stuff is crazy. And putting good money after bad, repairing this old piece of equipment, it's not a very smart idea.
Isn't there one transmission you need to...
And that's the one I'm talking about. We didn't use it all winter to count on that. The other day, we used it a little bit because we needed it. And the minute the oil gets hot in it, it starts to slip, so... You know, it's not something you want to get caught in the road with either. So I didn't know if the board intended to let me go through with it or wait it out.
Do you have a preference, which one do you want?
Well, the road's about the same.
I understand.
And from what I heard from town supervisor Moore this afternoon, he's not too satisfied with their machine they bought.
Well, this was a John Deere?
Yeah. They had to bring theirs to Governor to get it serviced. Wouldn't be pleased.
I wouldn't be either. Well, just want to okay to go order either one or
do yeah. You... Like I say, if I could have got the guy to call me back this afternoon to give me the full understanding of his warranty, I probably would have went with John Deere. But after I found out this afternoon what I heard from Morris, it kind of discouraged me a little bit.
Yeah.
Oh, there's a John Deere. Does it have to be serviced by John Deere or Field?
Well, if it's under warranty.
All right. So, but you'd have to go all the way to Governor if you could do it locally.
Well, either that or you bring it to Williston, Vermont.
Okay. Williston, Oklahoma.
Alan, you want to address the issue of time wise? I think you said it was 2 or 3 months before we get one, anyways.
60 to 90 days before we can get it.
Right.
And us, we need it for the sand. When we start bringing down our sand in the fall, we need one in the pit to screen. And then as the trucks are coming in, we need one to mix the salt and the sand and pile it at the same time. So, you know, I don't want to tie up the guys and, you know, say, hey, well, we're going to bring the loader back down because we've got a bunch of loads of the salt and pile up. It takes a pretty good loader here to pile that up.
Financing works out, I have no problem
with this. Oh, I spoke to Jane about it, and you know, it'll work out. This year, it probably won't because we got other things pending, we're paying, but as soon as this gets paid off, I'll be in good shape for next year.
And you can negotiate a 2 or 3 year payback?
Yeah, whatever, how we want to do it. We can tell better when we do the budget this fall. We want to go 3 years, 2 years. They're very accommodating how we want to do that. And the interest is 3%.
Which is reasonable.
Sure. Okay. Go ahead and just get out the discussion to...
Yeah, he's the one who's going to be using it.
The one who's going to use it. Just have a motion, maybe go ahead. The prices are almost exact.
Yeah, the only price he is different here is he gave me a quote of $112,300. The other one's $110,183. But the one that $110,83, I got to turn around and buy a 3 year warranty of $2,500. So it comes out to the same, it's a wash. They're both pretty much the same. I said these two guys talk together here.
Yeah, that John Deere one went for $110,000. What it said, it includes the John Deere standard warranty.
That's just a 1 year warranty that comes with the machine. Okay. After that 1 year is done.
Instead of 3 year like the other,
yep.
Which you end up paying for.
See, the problem with your warranties, they don't fully explain when you buy that. It's just like when we buy a truck. I got beat a couple years ago on a truck. They made us buy a warranty, $6,500 or whatever it was. In the course of the winter, the way we had little minor problems, little electrical problems, little this, little that. You send that truck down there the following year after the first year runs out. Well, electrical is only warranted for 1 year. This is warranted, the part is warranted, but the labor is not warranted. Well, you guys didn't explain that. That's what I want, is a better explanation. When they tell you we got a 3 year warranty.
Yeah. You think it's a 3 year warranty.
It's just like we got the case excavator we got. It's going to be paid off the 20th there. Well, it had 2,000 hours on it, so we needed a service. It was the last service. They sent a man here from Milton, Vermont, with 3 pails of oil and a bunch of filters. He was here an hour and a half on a Friday. I got a bill in the mail for $457, traveling time. Well, you didn't tell me that in that warranty that I had to pay mileage. The guy says, well, if you don't want to pay mileage, then load your machine, bring it to us. We won't. Well, if I'm going to do that, and you guys don't have a good explanation when you buy a warranty.
They tell you what they want to tell you.
Well, yeah, it sounds good. You know, oh, we got a 3-year warranty from head to toe, but it's not.
Okay.
They don't make a practice to write it down.
Well, they do. They give you a pamphlet like this. You go through it, and you got a lot of fine print there.
Disclosure's there.
She's going to find it.
Okay. It's the will of the board here. I consider it an opportunity to upgrade.
Okay. I'm getting rid of all the equipment that we're not using. I mean, it's no sense keeping it.
Yeah, it's old enough.
Well, one's an 86, the other one's an 88, and the other one's a 92 or something, you know?
Okay. I'll entertain a motion just to give Alan the discretion to go to order whichever one he wants.
I'll make that motion to...
There's no big difference on the price, so...
Yeah, I'll make that motion to give Alan the opportunity to move forward with securing this purchase.
Do I have a second?
A second.
Thank you. Any questions? Concerns? We'll have a roll call vote for this kind of money again. Rick?
Aye.
Brian?
Aye.
John?
Aye.
Clark?
Aye.
And I for myself, thank you. Okay. Some further business. We had I believe you all have the proposals that came today to me. Where's construction company? There's 4 different. Has everybody got a copy? You got one, John? Clark.
I have a copy.
What?
Where? Where's proposal?
Okay, you got one. John, you got one? This proposal, right on the top sheet, just
23, isn't it?
From like this. There's more. Brian, you got an extra?
I don't have an extra.
You got one now?
You got one, Clark?
I got extras.
I can.
No, 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 there, Clark. Alan?
Low on paper?
I got one.
Low on paper.
Brian and I and Alan went around last Friday with the Lawrence Construction Company to look at some hookups and some work to be done on the water project. We have 4 different bids. I did talk to our attorney late today on this one. I'm on your in order. Proposal number 164, would that be top right hand corner?
Absolutely.
Pardon?
Nothing, just...
And these are hookups on Route 11. Okay, there's actually 4 of them. Second contract is Derringer's Wire House. And put a line underneath the road there. And there's some concrete work, asphalt work. The third one is, I believe, 4 hookups on a Dubois Road and 1 on the Glover Road down. Is that
correct? Yeah, he's right there.
Okay. I did have Jane fax. He's up to Anthony. It was almost 4 o'clock when I did that. The gentleman wasn't in here until way after 3. The proposals. The recommendation is to approve these pending Anthony's okay and our attorney. For me to sign them, because we don't want to wait another month if we don't have to. Okay? But then again, if EFC has to approve these bids to the funding agency, so I just prefer not to wait a month. Or I could call an extra meeting, but Matt Fambrothot, by giving me permission to sign them after Anthony and our attorney okay, so it would be sufficient.
Now, is he taking care of all of the, like, the back of the houses where they put that water line in and filled in and everything?
Now, this has nothing to do with restorations.
This is nothing to do, this is all new, new stuff?
Yes. No restorations here. This is the hookups on the Duval's Road, 3-4 on Route 11, 4 I believe, and one at Derringer's. They got a punch underneath the road there to go from one building to the other. Okay. They say I sent these up to Anthony, I told him I'd be speaking with him in the morning. Matt Favreau was aware that I was gonna get these today, and he said, you know, if we can approve them pending their approval. It's a little board here, whatever you wanna do.
I'll make the motion that we approve pending authorization from the attorney and the engineer and the supervisor.
And actually, Anthony has to get approval from the EFC. That comes through Anthony. He has to call down there and get okay and do these projects, okay? It'll put us in pretty good light as far as hookups go. The only one I can think of after these is Beeline. Diesel's up on West Service Road, okay?
And this only include this one?
No, this is not in here. Beeline's not in here. That is the heavy duty one, so to speak. What are they gonna cut? West Service Road. Okay. Now, Anthony Young has asked Brandon Construction, the one that has the sewer line going in up there, to give us a quote on that also. They have not gotten it. The Warrior Construction is also wants to bid on that one. I would hope there's a lot of people that want to bid on it. Okay. The pipe itself is up there on site, 300-400 feet of pipe that was left there. They reached from the road to the building. So it's been the digging and covering up. But up in that area, you never know how much rock you're going to get into. That's the unknown up on the West River. So it's a little board, you want to talk about it, discuss it?
Clark, we...
I made the motion.
Anyone do that?
I didn't hear a
second. Can I have a second, then we'll have a discussion?
I'll second it.
Thank you. Any other, what's your thoughts?
How do you put your projection for this fitting into the overall balance? Is it coming out like we hope it would? Close?
Yes.
Okay.
I'm very hopeful if we can do these for this price. The other major installation is the cut across the road up on West Rivers Road, which could be $40,000-$50,000. That would still leave us in the neighborhood of a little better $200,000 for restorations.
Okay.
Okay. The EFC is going to keep a close eye on this problem, and rightfully so. They don't want to limit. This project, John, is a 30-year 0% loan, which is hard to beat, but still you got to qualify for it. And income levels in the township is what got us that loan at that price, at no interest. Okay. We already made one payment out of the 30 years last January, so we're not. Okay. Most people are, I haven't heard hardly any complaints at all about the water quality or anything. I'm hearing things about the restoration for sure. Okay. But another contractor was in this afternoon, way after 4 o'clock. He wants to take a look at a couple of major restorations for us, A to Z, which I had to go ahead and look at. There was a price, you know. As we were driving down Route 11, Alan, you could probably say some of them don't need a lot of work and some of them need a lot of work.
Some do need work.
Okay. This is a step we need to take as soon as possible. I certainly do not want to wait until June to get these approved, if the attorneys and our engineers approve. I think that's the right way to go. I don't know what your feeling is here. Okay. Because, you know, we're talking May. We've got 4 months, 5 months. As far as the restorations go, you want to do those as early as possible in the year to get a good. You're going to see down lawns, you want to do it in October or September either. So I think this is a step forward, pending the approval from our attorney and our engineers. Any questions? Well, then we'll call vote on this one too, then. Rick?
Aye.
Ryan?
Aye.
John?
Aye.
Clark?
Aye.
Aye, myself, aye, thank you.
And I might mention too that you are still pursuing the hydrant extensions.
We,
You made a couple calls today on that.
I did get a call from our attorney. John, you're not aware of this. We have approximately 16 fire hydrants that need to be extended up out of the ground higher. Okay. The contractor, after much discussion, that left us, sent us the extensions that we had paid for, so to speak, but they were aftermarket parts. They weren't the original parts. Okay? And the question now is, the manufacturer of the hydrant itself, will they honor their warranty with an aftermarket part attached to it? Okay. So that's what Matt Favreau was trying to find out, okay? Because apparently they will fit. But we don't want to lose, we did hold back $5,000 from the contractor, and we priced it out, the original parts that would match up perfectly. It's going to cost us around $7,000, which is only $2,000 more than what we held back. But as of today, the contractor wants his $5,000, he's going to sue us. And Matt told me it would cost $3,000 or more to litigate it for a $5,000 item. So
could we send back the parts we're not going to use?
What parts we're not going to use?
Well, if we choose not to use 15 extensions, then...
Yeah, we can send the parts back, he's going to sue us for the other $5,000.
We'll give him back his parts that we don't want, and we'll take that $5,000 along with the $2,000 and go out and get the correct ones.
I agree with you, but right. That's not what the... Am I right?
Yes.
Okay.
We're going to get sued. And to defend it would cost more than what the money is we have in the...
Matt's opinion was that we could litigate this for anything less than $3,000 on a $5,000 item. Is it worth it?
And also, he was concerned the letter said the warranty would only be void on the parts installed, but the manufacturer would still cover the parts separate from the parts, aftermarket parts.
It's a mess.
So it's a very fine line on the warranty, and that's what he's worried about. It gives them an opening to sale, an opening to sue us like they threatened, and there goes any money savings right there if you've got to fight the case in court, plus buy the new part.
And not only that, you sue somebody, it doesn't happen overnight. It could take a year or two, a couple years, who knows, you know? So that's, Matt Favreau's looking into that. He wants a clarification now from the original manufacturers of the hydrants to see if, in fact, it does avoid the warranty. Okay, here and there. Okay. I'm sure the manufacturer would probably like to get away from the warranty if they could. That's them off the hook. It'll help it. In good faith, we bought hydrants with warranties. In good faith, we did a lot of things that didn't quite work. Okay.
What would be the cost of having to repair a hydrant if it malfunctioned?
The hydrant itself?
Well, and it had to do with the extension.
Does anybody know the mechanics
of a fire agent?
Oh, certainly. Mike Jolly knows this. He's up on it.
You just open one up and water. What? Is there a valve in there?
Yeah, it's a valve.
Yeah, but when you raise...
There's a valve next to it, you want to shut it off.
Oh, right. Okay.
But when you raise the hydrant, you can raise them 6, 12, or 18 inches. When you do that, you've got to have a longer stem down, point out of it. Okay, mm-hmm. You got to add on to the stem. It's not just like...
You can't just put it in there.
It's not that easy. If it was that easy, it would have been done a long time ago. And Mike Chowder has agreed to switch out the extensions for us.
Alongside Route 11, from the old medical center down, the other pass. They're too low.
Oh, right.
They get buried with snow, you know, you get a fire down there, you can't use it, you know, you gotta dig them out.
So I guess that's, that issue is only for information only. We'll have to work with our attorney on that. Julie, you have anything?
Well, just this, this first there.
Pardon?
I'm gonna do this now.
Yep, go ahead.
Water District number six disbursement approval number 44. Bernie and Carr for $3,693.28.
Okay. I need a motion to approve. I guess they're gonna get their share as long as the project is ongoing.
I'll make the motion to pay the.
Thank you.
I'll second that.
Thank you.
Say what it's for. Specifically what it's for.
I don't have that in front of me.
Julie? On the paper, it's a say what it's for.
Yeah.
No, it's kind of broken down.
That's all.
Basic services, but it's a balance to be invoiced.
Why is the question Anthony on that?
Sorry, I asked. I'm sorry.
Wait till you see it.
That's all right.
I see why. It's not an easy description.
That's all right.
John, these are monies that's coming out of the water project. We have to approve them. They go to EFC, funding agency in Albany. It's Environmental Facilities Corporation. And they approve in about a week, 10 days. They wire the money to our bank. Then we send it back.
Check out Bernie and Carr, are they engineers?
It's right, pardon, yeah.
They're the engineers on the project.
Right at the bottom of the page here, John will go sign up. It's like, I'm not sure I can wear it, but the second word is on our home.
We got a red pen in there, right? Signed it right.
Did you? It's okay. Okay, I need a motion to, you post out the bills, you can review those. Remember the ongoing monthly bills, John, you post out the ones. You know, the things that we have to pay, the unemployment insurance, taxes that we take out, paycheck and stuff, send them into the government. They're mandatory. This second page, voucher edit, maybe, is that that one? Okay, these are the monthly bills. Let me ask for a motion to approve, then I'll ask for any concerns. May I have a motion to approve the monthly bills?
I'll make a motion to approve the monthly bills.
Thank you. Do I have a second?
I get a second.
Thank you. Now, is there any questions or concerns about the monthly bills? And please go over them. Okay. Some are just a few bucks, some are a few hundred dollars. Okay.
We're still buying bottled water, and we have good town water now?
We don't have town water there, I wish we.
Well, we should fix it then.
I wish we did have.
Yeah, there's a problem with our well. There's a problem with our well and disinfection system.
Well, I think we should bring in some of the town, new water system.
Yes.
I'll bring in a couple of pictures for our next meeting with less ice.
If you want to just.
We have to see bottled water out here.
We've put a lot of money into our water system here for, am I right, Alan, disinfecting?
Non-ending battle, that water system, the other end here.
We spent at least, what, $15,000 or more? We have a ultra, is it ultraviolet?
Ultraviolet.
System. It hasn't been free of problems, let's put it that way.
You still can't drink it.
How long's it been in?
It's got to be in 3-4 years now.
Yeah.
Another thing perfect, yeah, parking lot.
Yes.
We had, been talking about it for 2-3 years now, paving, repaving the parking lot. I got a call from Brian Belkey. I want to put two lights here in the parking lot for the judges when they bring somebody to court at night.
Right, right.
It's not very well lighted. Close to the building is, but on this end it isn't. So where do you park the cars? I could put two lights there, eliminate that pole in the middle. And I get the lights from Brian, he wants $1,000 a piece through Village Ross Point and sell them to us $1,000 a piece.
Is that pole on there now?
Yeah, that's a pole with an arm. Just like they got the street lights there.
Okay.
And that's a, you don't have to put a cement base. It's a base that they screw in the ground. You must have seen them there. It's not cement. So I don't know if the board wants to go along with it, put the lights and I can get it paid in summer.
Who would install the lights?
I think Brian would be there. It's bad here. I know I plow the parking lot sometimes at night here. It's not well lighted on this end. Especially when somebody, they bring somebody into court. See, there's a light across the road that faces the court. There's one in the corner here. But let's say a trooper wants to park up over here, it's not, you know. It's not well lighted.
Okay, just for information, as far as paving of the parking lot, we're only thinking about, if I'm correct, Alan, this half of it.
Yeah, that could go from the corner to court, this, going this way.
This way.
Yeah, the highway side, we can wait another year for that. It's not badly broken or nothing. This side's bad.
And the county will.
Well, the county had told me earlier that they'd like to get it paved if we could do the side before we pave the roads. So I got a little work to do out here before we pave. I don't know if the board still wants to do these, guys still want to do it. We talked about it last couple of years.
We've been talking about it for quite a while.
I know.
And it's not going to get any cheaper?
No, and it keeps getting worse because in the wintertime when the tar's all cracked, it's like this, when you plow it, you're always taking a chunk out.
Is there money in the budget for it?
There was money put in last year for it.
So why did it not?
Yeah, if it's there, I said we do it.
Yeah, we had put money, 2 years ago we put money in the budget. We didn't do it.
I believe the lights would come out of building maintenance, am I correct?
Yeah.
Which we have money in that too. Okay.
Yeah, I only got one problem, that new electrical line that we put in from the road follows the edge of the tarmac here, goes to the back of that main box here. So I got to find that line, so when those pegs in the ground, then we don't hit that.
How deep is it, do you know that?
4 feet.
It's 4 foot deep. You got to make sure you don't hit it with a backhoe.
Yeah, you got to call.
I'll get a guy from NYSEC to come here and find it for me.
Okay. We have a problem either one of the lights or the pavement.
I'll get it going sometime in summer, you know, Brian, I'll get the lights.
See Brian, I can see Brian, oh, I didn't see him anyway, I'll see him tomorrow, I'll tell him, you know.
Get the lights in first and we'll be here.
I see him, I'm still waiting.
I don't believe we passed the bills today.
Well, we have motion in second.
Yes. Talking about other things. Get back to the monthly bills. I have a motion in a second. Is there any questions on any of the bills? If not, all those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Carry. Thank you. Does anybody else have anything to bring before the board?
Just a question.
Yes.
I got confirmation from the superintendent at Northeastern that we will be getting a backstop for a cost of $1. Larry tells her we have it covered. And then from there, we'll have to work on the details as far as getting it from there up to her as well. And I had a brief meeting with Kevin Regan, the cable guy.
Cable franchise agreement.
Yeah, and we talked about this, and I was basically taking me to school to understand all this. But it looks like he's simply renewing the contract, the town getting 3%. And probably want to push for 10-year rather than 15. That's identical what the village is doing. I was kind of waiting to see what was happening there, and if they got some special deal, maybe we could piggyback off of them. That's when they recently struck that agreement. So I'll contact him and ask him to send the paperwork.
John, just for information, I'm with the cable franchise company in the area.
They give us back quarterly payments equal to 3% of the total bills.
We could ask for more, if always we could, but if we had asked for more, they're going to add it onto the bills. That's not what we want for our.
They had some other thing around this point.
Okay, so I say if we can sign a contract as is, but whatever appropriate term, go ahead and do it. Anybody else? I didn't forget that. If I did, it will be a special meeting. Need a motion to adjourn?
I'll make a motion to adjourn.
Thank you.
Second.
Thank you. All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you. Anybody opposed? I want to know why. Thank you, Galvin.